Welcome back, my friends. My name is Eric, and this is Rome, and we're back to more MechWarrior 5 Mercenaries. This is the Rise of WrestleHack DLC. We're playing a fairly modded version. Get another mech lab, among others. Now, last time we removed the higher employment, whatever it's called, and we went with the better... I don't even remember what it's called now. Hold on. Give me a second. I will figure it out again. Where is my mod manager? I've already forgotten what the heck the thing is called. It is Better Mission Choices Mod. Now, I noticed in between as I was saving this, I came back, I noticed that we have this up here. And I'm wondering if we can go talk, if that will fix that. Like, did we miss something? Is it fixed? View transmissions, is it back? Oh, we got the Waco Rangers. We got that mission. Okay. Someone told me that determination becomes obsession, and then it becomes all that matters. I've always reminded of that quote whenever I think of Wayne Waco and his Waco Rangers. When the Compelling Confederation decided to disband the First House City Rangers, Wayne's natural charisma and upbeat outlook on life inspired loyalty and kept a large majority of the disbanded unit together as they ventured out on their own. But that positivity was the first thing to be crushed under the foot of some stalker that pancaked his son John on New Aragon. As the stories go, the Rangers were facing off against Zeta Battalion, Wolf's Dragoon's fancy battalion that fields almost exclusively assault mechs. Wouldn't know anything about that. John's Lance of Scout mechs were shot down, igniting smoke screens to blind Zeta's lumbering slow movers. John successfully ejected out of the cockpit, but when he was running across an open field attempting to link up with another Ranger mech, trying to rescue him, a Dragoon stalker maliciously crushed John under his mech's boot, under his mech's foot as he fled for his life. Comstar Inquiry cleared Wolf's Dragoons of any wrongdoing, but that only pushed Wayne even further off the edge. Now the charisma and optimism he's known for has been replaced with bitterness and rage. To his credit, he has tempered his fury into forging his Rangers and becoming the Dragoon's ultimate foil, even if their rivalry with Jamie Wolf seemed to be purely one-sided, as the Dragoons seem to show little regard to Wayne's blood feud with them. Okay. Got that. There's the goblin one. I guess it's just because we have it linked. I mean, I guess we could try to go back and do it again. It's still showing up. Let's see. I don't know if that's going to fix the problem or not. It's up here. Let's go ahead and see if we can finish this one here. We decided that there was, let's try this one and see. Then we'll maybe head north and see if we can get that. Get that pilot recruited again. See if the problem was a conflict maybe with the higher employment mod. All right, we got one here. Go to the free worlds and collect the low-key encrypted transmission, hopefully. This one is for independence against, the periphery realms, who doesn't seem to like me very much. I mean, I guess.
Mind the weather, Commander. It'll compromise your visibility.
Nothing's fixed yet. Or do they need to be fixed? Is that what they're telling me? I don't know. Probably. We probably didn't fix them last time. All right. I'm going to take the Rome. I'm going to take... Crash Lander, Rooster, Monkey.
We've been hired to Red for supplies.
Oh, the snow again. Everything seems to have snow or rain now.
On this mission, Commander. I'll give you the okay once you're in target range.
I think we can go ahead, hit that, and then just go straight across the north branch there.
Intel puts one of our
That'll be perfect.
Acquisitions somewhere in this location. If you get the chance, try searching for it in the area designated on your map.
All right, we'll do. I think we can do that. Got a patrol coming up.
Target acquired.
Have to remember what the
armor vehicle radar.
Target destroyed.
Target destroyed.
Thank you, Weaver.
All group, this is Sierra 2-1. Be advised, strike payload is ready and awaiting your tango.
All right.
Sierra 2-1 out.
Target destroyed. New target, Urban Mech.
Oh, I'm gonna go to here so I can see him. If I took off the arm, that doesn't matter. Let everybody else finish him. Let's get in here and see what we're supposed to blow up or recover.
Tango down.
Target acquired. Target destroyed.
Grab loot. I don't see said loot at the moment. Hmm. Search for salvage. I think I just did. I don't see anything. Oh, there it is. There it is. It's all the way back there. Got it. Okay. I'm just gonna park them there while I run back here and grab this. No reason to have them try to follow me around through here.
If you find the acquisition, just walk up to it in order to pick it up.
Holding at location.
Got it.
Commander, dual units, unidentified battle mechs on the field. Take them out.
Well, somebody's out there. All right, let's go see if we can find out whoever this dude is out here who's talking. Looks like we can run right down this ramp, get to our next section.
Target acquired. Target destroyed.
As well as get to the next item we need to recover. I have the longest range, but I also am the fastest in this group, it looks like. Oh, found that one right away. SRM?
Target acquired.
Target received. Engaging.
That's close enough. Ready to start pickup operation.
I'll grab this. If he's still alive. Don't think he is.
One down.
I think Bandit got the turret there. Good job, Crash. See if we can find this bit.
That hidden asset should be close, Commander.
Grab it. Rolling through this. One more location. Back in a minute. All right, we're gonna push. We've got Crash and Magnetic Monkey. They're back a little ways. I don't think we'll need them though, so we're gonna push now. They'll catch up when they catch up. And there it is right there. That's what we need. So in the meantime, the Rooster and I take care of whatever we need to take care of. And we'll get out of here. Where do we... Okay, hold on. That direction. Where is... Oh, it's on this side. All right, well, I'm gonna walk out there and we'll be back in a minute. That was a good shot. All right, we got a Loki encrypted transmission. We get a couple points of that. Is there anything else there? No. No, there's not. I guess that'll work. And nobody else could really keep up with me except Weaver. Everybody else is a little bit slow for that. Let's go ahead and finish that. Didn't get us too far, but it got us something. All right, I'm going to try flying all the way back here. We're going to try one more time. See if we can get to there. We'll take it in some easy stages. Hero Crusader, huh? Heavy Arena Fist. Looks pretty cool. Regular Marauder 3M. A Thug. PPC's SRM4s. Not too bad. Let's take a look at the barracks real fast. Let's see, see if there's any training we can do.
Commander, now let's kick them right in the gondola.
Let's get a move on. Time is money and we're wasting both.
Oh, happy to be a part of this, Commander. Let's get to it.
Dragon reporting.
Chainsaw reporting.
Glad you joined the company, Commander. Let's kick some ass.
I think we get him an extra one, right? Because he's only got one so far.
Finally! Got something for me, big boss?
Exploration and fortune has brought us to meet. Glad to be...
You pay me, I fight for you. Deal?
Glad you joined the company, Commander. Let's kick some ass.
Who else was it?
Glad to join the company,
no,
Commander.
He had plenty.
Let's get a move on. Time is money and we're wasting both.
Try to get everybody up to at least three. You know what I'm saying?
Consider it done.
You're already at three.
You pay me.
I don't care about the extra non-channel members.
You pay me.
Prepped and ready, Commander.
But you've already trained. All right, perfect. That's fine. Oh, what did it give him?
Let's kick some ass.
I don't know which one he had initially.
Let's get a move on.
Because it does just kind of instantly give it to me.
Both.
Oh, well. Star map. Let's keep going. Nope. Nothing that looks like what we need it to be. As soon as we get here, it disappears. Let's take a look at transmission, see if there's a transmission from him. Don't see anything. Okay. Star map. Let's go. Have we met them yet? Blackhearts, yes, we've met them. We've met you. We've met all of you. We haven't met you yet. Let's go there. Can't quite get there. I'm happy to fly long distance. We're trying to get up about six more years, essentially, so we can get up to the clans, and then I'd love to run the clan invasion mod, as well as the, you know, we've got the additional mech mods, you know, like the classic mod collection and the mech assault, which have a number of clan specific mechs that we're not going to see until we get to that timeline. So I don't mind flying a little extra. Could do that. Now I think we just keep looking. We want to get over to here. Any contracts here? Yeah, we've got a beachhead. Oh, these are difficulty 100. Nice. That one, but they're not great missions, are they? Bandits against Comstar. Or bandits against Merrick. I'd rather piss off Comstar. Well, that's not true, but in the context of this, I would rather to do this one. A scorched earth and an objective raid. Those seem pretty reasonable. We'll go for some salvage. I forgot to fix stuff. Hey, we're getting up to the point where our pilots are happy with the number of missions they've got. Let's go ahead, because we're going to need these mechs fixed. There we go. We do have enough mechs here. We did finish Danny's mech there. So we'll throw Lieutenant Slingo in action there. I guess I'll take the Morningstar. We'll throw Aaron into that one. I think she's on the second page there.
And
what mech do we have left? We've got the Crashlander. All right. Where's Bandit? He is down here.
Shh. Be very quiet.
to destroy a local military facility. Be cautious of any live ordnance storage they might have on site. Farhad does not want to spend weeks clearing shrapnel from shredded my army bundles. Something's wrong, Commander.
We found him right away.
Dropship closing in on your position.
Destroy the mercenaries. Oh, I shut down. Hold on. Let's get back in the fight here. Oh, we saw that thug for sale a second ago. Oh, I shut down again, damn it. Oh, hold on, it's screwing with my weapon grips too. There we go, let's fix that. Somehow that got changed. Yes, it was. Oh, it was Big Mac.
Those mercs will think twice before trying that again. Looks like you don't need evac anymore. See you when the mission's complete.
Well, good. We get a little bit of revenge for them from Kestrel Lancers, right? Suck it, Big Mac. All right, let's see what else we can do here. We got a long ways to walk, though. We'll be back in a few minutes. Well, there they are. Go around here. Somebody got a headshot in there on that Phoenix Hawk. I can't even see him between all the LRMs flying in. I'm gonna ignore him for a moment. I think he's done. Sure looks to me. I can step on you. Everybody just ignored that Phoenix Hawk once we took his weapons off of him.
Enemy mech down.
You didn't need legs, did ya? Kinda looks like you might have. Danny's like actively pushing me out there. He's like, no, this is mine.
Target destroyed.
Okay. I'll just kind of zigzag through these real quick. Kind of hit the diagonals. Alright, who we got? They're gonna come right on top of us. Could be big.
This area is on its last legs, Commander. Just one final push, and then we can all go home.
It's difficult to make do without your C2E though. Just saying. Difficult for me to make do without my CT too. Somebody want to shoot him? There goes the AC-20. I think he's outside the wall there. All right.
We expect our employer to be very satisfied with this result. Head to the Eva point for extraction.
How'd I go?
Target is done.
Let everybody else do a little bit of tanking here. We should have got Aaron some points for that, huh? Looks like there's a ramp right here in the middle. Hey, Roush, how you doing, man? I am doing excellent. Happy to see somebody in this one. No, I didn't notice. You were quiet. You're more than allowed to speak up when you're in. That's the whole point. Oh, okay. Well, for anybody else watching, any of your members, you're more than welcome to hop in Discord and kibitz and talk while we're in the missions. I am trying to stream every recording session into Discord. And for the rest of you, you're more than welcome to watch. You just don't have a live mic, but you can talk into general or type, and more than welcome. This is me easing back into streaming and as gentle and graceful and easy as I can make it for myself. Hey, we got Intel level 6. Killing big. We're working towards it. That's the goal. I'm just trying to kill 6 years till we get to that point. Yeah, that's kind of what I'm treating it as. And that's why I'm willing to like fly all over the place, because it takes time and maybe we won't get rich that way. But we can make more than enough to pay for it. Holy cow. The upgrades to the, you haven't seen them yet, I don't think. We upgraded the Stalker to all LRM-15s instead of LRM-10s. With XL, I think just XL is what I needed. So this is its first run out since then. So the fact that it topped all comers for damage, that's nice, it means it worked. You weren't in this one, unfortunately. Well, that's it. And the first episode I recorded today, I kind of wanted to see how the AI would do with the Corsair and how it would do with Aaron's now with those N-therm missiles. And the dual Gauss of the Corsair, it was just able to kill things before Aaron got a chance to shoot at him. You know, it was just the range. You know, I think we've got some mechs that can do a couple of mechs now that'll do long range distance damage, but you know, when things get in close, all of a sudden mechs like yours or like the Morningstar start to shine. Yep. Definitely. Let's see, what do we get? Fully properly got a nice refurbished heavy mech I'm willing to part with in the repair bay now. Step up and get, oh, okay. So next level we get a mech. We get a heavy mech out of the next level with the bounty hunter, I guess is what we're getting. We got the paint scheme for the heavies now. We could bail on this one. The only point to do it was to fight Big Mac, and we got that, but I think we'd go again. Let's, since we're talking to him, let's throw a long shot in there. And if I can find you, go. Let's throw the Roman back there for some long range. And Rooster, another mech that's more or less set up for... Most of us are set up to brawl, honestly. Where is he? Which is fine, because that tends to be the only strategy I'm capable of carrying out.
Shh, be very quiet.
Right, right. Actually, I've just realized we've been talking. For those of you that are wondering why I'm going crazy and why you're not hearing who I'm talking to, it's because I don't have OBS set up to throw Roush in there. So I'm glad you're shy because nobody's heard you up to this point, man. I've got to add, give me a second here. I'm going to add an audio source while we're talking. I didn't even think about that until I just looked over at my audio channels there and we didn't see anything. Audio...
12 seconds later.
All right, say something now, please, sir.
Oh, sure.
There we
testing,
go.
Testing, testing, 1, 2.
We gotcha. I gotta lower the level a little bit, but I think we've got it licked.
Nice. So, for all the people who didn't hear my side of the conversation, I'm shy.
That's right. So we blocked it on purpose to let him ease himself into it as well. There we go. That's my excuse. We're sticking with it. All right. Are you seeing the stream okay on your end on Discord?
Yes.
All right.
I'm seeing everything just fine.
Perfect. I can put the camera on too, but I think you kind of have to choose which one you want to choose. And so I figured it was just easier to see the game rather than to see me.
Our employer wants us to destroy a number of communication towers located at the marked objectives. I'm reading a heavy amount of hostile chatter in the area, so let's get this done and get that.
I gotta admit, this is the one map that I really don't like of Vaughn's.
As far as the biome?
Yeah. It just seems so cluttered.
Yeah, there's a lot on it. And it makes it hard. Actually, it does benefit you, I think, a little bit, your mech, because everything's close range because there's so much in the way, you can't make long distance shots, you know?
Yeah.
But I think this one's all going to be here in the city and it won't matter.
My biggest problem more is the pathing.
Oh, yes.
On your mini map, you don't see everything that's blocking you.
Yeah.
So you end up just wandering around so much.
Yeah, I've noticed the spaceport's the same way, you know, because a lot of the big stuff doesn't show up as terrain, but does block your turret, you know.
Yeah.
This is going to be a big one. Let's try to take care of the little guys here first. Because we are going to go... There's a lot of targets on the table already.
So, I was watching Baradol, and he took out the TP rules. Evidently, it interferes with some of the upgrades to the AI.
Which one does that? I'm sorry, I missed it over the explosions.
The TT rules? Lancemate?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Evidently, it interferes with some of the upgrades to the AI, so they aren't quite as good with the TT rules, at least as of yet.
Yeah, I chose not to install it at all simply because of that. I figured the new AI does what Tabletop Rules is supposed to do, right? You know, I mean, it clips,
yeah.
You know, that... Oh, I completely whiffed that AC-20 shot. I didn't run it on purpose for that, even though generally I do. The thing I missed, though, is because of that, I don't have,
the Lancemate rules?
Yeah, I can't give the extra commands. Yeah, exactly, the rules. So, I do miss that. I would like one where I can just do the rolls. I don't need the AI changes, per se, or big AI changes. I just want to be able to make kind of...
I think those are listed as two separate downloads.
They are, but I kind of thought one was necessary for the other, but maybe not. Maybe it's worth experimenting with just to see. Because I'd love, you know, because we have some pilots that, you know, have their own inbuilt proclivities. You know,
right.
For instance, we've got Slingo in this one, and we put him in a stalker, but he likes to, the character himself likes to brawl, you know?
Yeah.
And so he always, which is fine, I don't mind a little active LRM play. It would be nice to be able to add a little bit more weight to the roles we need taken care of, you know?
Right. Assign him as the missile boat.
Exactly. Yeah, you know? I would love to be able to figure out how they do those things, too, because I'd like to be able to, if and when I start figuring out the modding for this, I would love to be able to create the custom pilots for y'all that have kind of the personalities you want them to have.
I gotcha.
We can weight that AI to do... what is that? Oh, it's a tank.
Just sit there and go in and make the character for Slingo.
Yeah.
And he automatically becomes that role.
Do you see this tank up on his treads?
Yeah.
I have a friend of mine that was a Bradley driver in the National Guard for a while, and he actually did manage to high center a Bradley on a stump. Drove it right up, and all the treads were up in the air.
Ready to start pickup operation.
My brother worked on Hueys for the Marine Corps for 20 years.
Oh, okay. My uncle was a Marine Corps helicopter pilot and a test pilot for a while, so who knows? He might have signed off on some of those repairs.
It's possible.
His last job was actually Navy Reserve. He was the squadron commander at Point Magoo for Special Combat Search and Rescue.
Hmm. My brother did.
Enemy vehicle destroyed.
Like going to Afghanistan and all those places.
Hmm.
So
Cicada is trying to hide behind some solar panels. I got news, and they're like apparently bulletproof solar panels. See, this is one of those terrains that doesn't show up as terrain, and so the AI doesn't know how to walk around it. I ran into that with a city one where a monkey was just running into the side of a wall of a ramp.
That's right. He was on, like, a solar dish.
Yeah, so, but it didn't show up as something he needed to avoid, so he didn't. It didn't have the right collision stuff, I guess, built in. I'm not really sure exactly how it works, if I'm honest, for the map stuff. I kind of looked a little bit and said, yeah, I don't understand this, and ran away screaming. Might be worth it. I wonder if Vaughn would do Vaughn Seiten would do like an interview. You know, we could do like a podcast talking about some of the difficulties.
That would be cool.
I know we get Perpetrator to do it for a clan invasion. And we might be able to get Bear and some other guys from the crew there to do that. I think there's another tank standing up on its end there because it doesn't think it's a building.
Makes it easy for someone to walk around the corner and kill, though.
Yeah.
Cargo acquired.
I don't even remember what we're supposed to be doing on this one. Complete all objectives. We haven't even got close to the objective. I'm just killing stuff and talking. There's a lot of stuff on the map, though. Let's see. Are we supposed to be blowing something up? And I'm still, like, not going anywhere near it. There we go. Oh, yeah, they got hit. Oh, it looks like we got to blow something up over here.
I know that the Stalker is one of, if not your favorite,
Wait,
mech. What mech do you wish that they would add to the game?
I don't know. I think most of the stuff I like is in, because I'm an Inner Sphere guy, you know? So for me, I don't miss the Clan stuff. When I started playing the game, the Clan invasion wasn't a thing.
Yeah.
You know, so there was some... For me, the biggest issue were kind of the unseen mechs. Has that happened? Because I started out with Warhammer and Rifleman being my two favorites. I bought some die-cast models at the local... drugstore, pharmacy, actually, in Miles City, Montana, which blows my mind that it was carrying die-cast models for, you know, what were essentially... Oh, hey, we got an Annie up here. For what was essentially anime type of stuff, you know, at the time, you know? That we couldn't get in the U.S. because there was nobody doing good... at the time, anime was traded amongst people on VHS tapes. You know, if you wanted one, my buddy was into that. And they had these magazines that were just big lists, right? And you said, oh, I've got this, this, and this, and somebody would rend you a letter and you would make a copy for them, you know? Dubs were a bunch
I got
of guys
from comic book conventions.
Yeah, exactly. You know, that sort of stuff. And so it just blows my mind that it was there. But the fact that they disappeared due to that at some point was the stuff that bothered me the most, you know, later. And once that kind of stuff all got taken care of, that was kind of the last of it. You know, the King Crab I love. Really what I really wish is just that the game allowed various mechs to actually fulfill their roles better. Like that there were actual reasons to run different types of mechs, you know?
Right.
I'd love to see some more, like the Raven's a mech I like a lot, but there's really very little reason to run ECM or an ECM specific mech.
I'm not sure I like the way that this game handles the stats of the pilots, right?
Mm-hmm.
Because all it does is give you additional damage, you know, things like that. It doesn't make you more accurate, doesn't, you know.
Yeah. So I guess it's that. I do like kind of the new infiltration stuff. I don't know. I'm not sure. I like the idea that they gave us a reason to take a light mech that might have ECM on it. Like, that's great. I don't think it went quite far enough. I'd like to see it tie together. Like, I would love to see a mission where you go in, you spot where all the bad guys are, and then your next mission is to go in and kill those guys, right? But now you know where everybody is, right? And you can, maybe it's a, you know, you can pick and choose as you go. I would love to see something like that where those benefits are kind of cross-pollinate back and forth.
I wish that they would combine the assassination and the infiltration missions. Like, mm-hmm. You got to go in with your light mech, avoid all the sensors, but kill one target.
Yeah.
And then you evacuate.
Yeah, exactly. Where you go in with the light mech, you find them, then you call the drop in on top of them. You know, there's huge stuff around, and so if you dilly-dally, you're going to get crushed. But you get in first, you get the hit, and then you get out, you know?
And that's what the Raven was really well known for, was it would run that ECM and get in there under the radar and just...
Yeah, and they even talk about it in some of the missions, you know, when you're doing the Kestrel Lancers, you know, they make a big deal. Oh, they've got Ravens. We got to shut down those Ravens so we can see what else is out here, right? But we just give it lip service and some dialogue. You know, it never actually really does any of that.
And, you know, for me, like, if I could choose any one mech to be in this, you know, they've already got the Marauder 2C, which is one of my favorite mechs. But that's in the Clan Invasion, and... the Clan Invasion didn't change the appearance of the mech because, like, the ballistic weapon with center mounted on the clan version. From what I remember.
Yeah.
So it was sitting right over instead of on a side torso or whatever.
Correct. Yeah. Yeah, it's closer to this classic model that we got. I think that has the projectile right in the center. Exactly. More of the Robotech style. Kind of the skinny willowy with the big gun right in the middle. Let's see, where did we... Somebody had light Gauss, but apparently we didn't get a looted. Not seeing it in the list here. Oh, there's regular Gauss. Oh, there it is. There's a light Gauss. I saw the ammo for it. I'm like, where is the actual weapon? Did we get lucky? So we did pick up a light Gauss here and get some ammo. And I think I saw a couple large pulse lasers. Those could be cool on something.
Yeah.
I'm going to finish off the cicada because we got enough points for that. We could build another cicada or two if we wanted to, I guess. May as well. Just sell it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I don't know. It might be one too many. We'll go for that. Did I miss a Locust? No, I don't have it installed. As I say, did I miss a Locust Pirate? But I don't have the Clan Invasion mod installed yet with the Pirate Mechs on it yet. So we're okay. I just misread something. Weaver cleaned up 1,700 damage. And what I think of honestly is our weakest Brawly Mech, but that was the map for him. My God. Well, there we go. I mean, that just shows what we were talking about, it, right? You get a map where all of a sudden you don't have the vision that you have on other maps, and the Brawly Mechs come out ahead. You know, he did 300 damage more than the Rome. He did 500 damage more than the Marauder with the PPCs. Did more than me.
Well, you know, for me, I already told you what my ideal upgrade from the Cyclops is, that Stone Rhino.
Yes.
And I know it's going to be like 8 more years before it even gets introduced. But I know that there's Mad Dog. There were like 7 different mechs in the mod that I had suggested to install besides that classic.
Yep. And we did get them. Again, we're just waiting on the timeline. So, in fact, as long as we're here, hold on, I'm going to save here because I think we're kind of at the end of this episode anyway.
Okay.
Hold on, let me back up. I'm going to exit to title and we'll hop into the instant action and we can show people some of the mechs that we're talking about here that we've added but haven't made an appearance in game yet due to lore reasons. So, he is wise as the man who does not eat yellow snow. That was the tip there at the bottom. I guess as Canadian developers, they know something about that. It doesn't matter. We're just looking at mechs. We can pick whatever mission we want. Out there, Commander. Expect limited visibility and sensor malfunctions. Well, we've got the Adder right here. That's going to be one that gets introduced. So that might be another clan mech, mech rather than what we're looking for. See, I'm not sure I'm going to be able to tell the difference on all of these. Highlander 2C. I think this comes from...
Yeah, another clan mech.
Is that a clan mech mod? The model looks more like the little fancier than some of the others.
I think the 2C.
We'll look at some of just the straight clan ones as we go down here. Here we go. So these are ones that are part of the Mech Assault one. I did this one in a thumbnail the other day. So there's our Atlas. We've got... I may as well just select them here so we can see them a little bit bigger. Back down here to M. There's the Bilal. We've seen, I think, the Catapult in a mission, right? We saw the Catapult and the Bowman in one of them, I think. And they are out there in the world at the moment. Let's see, where's your Summoner, Timberwolf, Uziel, Vulture... Guys, get some idea what they look like. Let's find the Stone Rhino here. Here we go. This is the one we're We're looking at, he's a short, stubby little guy in this one.
Yeah, all it is modified Matar.
Well, it was brought up in one of the videos, too, that comment that the Marauder looked a little small. I think, to be honest, the Marauder model is on... my phone's ringing. I think it's actually correct. I think it's the rest of the... You know, we know that, that Piranha made these... Calm down. I'll call him back in a minute. Piranha made the mechs too big just because they looked cooler huge, right?
Yeah.
You know, they're supposed to be 30 feet tall for the big boys, you know? So three stories, right? People shouldn't be ants, you know? They should be, you know, ankle high, you know? Maybe a little bit more than that, depending on the mech. So I think really the Marauder is just to scale, and I think that's going to be some of these people that are making their own models or bringing their own models in. They're bringing them in at the correct scale. And these, the rest of them are just way too big. You know, I mean, we see what the Atlas there is versus, Atlas. We'll just bring one in here. Well, actually, that's pretty close. Those are about the same height in this case. So I think that's part of it, but,
also the Glaush, the way the, how skinny it is and everything makes it look so much smaller than the, Marauder from MWO.
Yes.
Yeah.
Definitely. I'll bring up a couple here. Here's the that one and heavy. Marauder Classic. There we go. Oh, they're called Classic. Is that the only one that they called Classic?
Yeah, so the seven, let me bring it up on my computer really quick, because I have it already open somewhere.
Here we go. Let's grab you. So, actually, you're right, it's just that they're skinny. They're about exactly the same height.
Yeah.
It's just the...
It just seems small, it isn't actually, so...
And it's more a lot more leg. You know, if we take a look at kind of where the pelvis starts, you know... you know, it's above this yellow line on this one, so it's up here. So yeah, it's a lot more leggy than the new kind of bulky kind of
the
dude
seven is. From the list that I suggested, the Marauder Classic, the Hellbringer. So these won't have the MA in front of it. They'll just be
right.
Marauder Classic, Hellbringer.
Here's the Hellbringer.
Summoner, Mad Dog, Hellcat, Timberwolf, and Stone Rhino.
Well, here we'll bring the Timberwolf in. Of those, I've always been a big Timberwolf fan of the clan when it comes to stuff.
It's such an iconic.
Although to be fair, I don't know. The arms on all of them that are essentially just a catapult with like Lego arms on the side. I've always thought it was a lazy model, to be honest, to design. They're like, well, we'll just stick some silly little arms on the side. That'll work.
Well, when you compare it to the Glaush, the classic Marauder, it makes more sense
right.
how they got them confused.
Yeah.
Because if you look at the arms, it looks just alike.
Yep.
So it really does. It just looks like a catapult with the Glaush's arms.
Now, we are running into a lot of invalid weapons on these, so I got to figure out where they're pulling their weapons from, because I have all the requirements that they list, but we're not seeing...
I think it might be part of the clan invasion.
Oh, that makes sense. So if we get there, we throw clan invasion in, even though it says it just needs the yet another clan mech.
Right.
It might come from that. That makes sense. Have to play with that. But, cool. Anyway, guys, this is what we've got. What we've got coming up, we got, like I said, about 6 or 8 more years, but it'll go fast because we're wasting a lot of time. Whoops, I'm trying to want to confirm. Yes, I'm trying to get back. Exit to menu. There we go. You know, because we're wasting a month or two flying between each system, so it'll go fast as we work on that. I'm gonna end this one here. Want to thank Roush for stopping.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, man. No, I'm glad to have you in. I'm probably going to do another episode this evening and probably two more tomorrow sometime so I can get all 5 of them done this weekend.
All right. So I look forward to watching them.
I got it set up. So for the rest of you out there, you're not going to see this till later in the week. But, you know, we're here on Discord. We've got the custom roles set up in Discord. So if you tie your Discord account to your YouTube account, there's a way to kind of tie those together. It will automatically put you into the correct member role. If not, you don't want to do that for some reason, which is completely acceptable. I do have a custom member role created for those that don't want to tie it to it. And all of those get voice privileges within this channel. So I guess we'll leave it there. Thanks for watching, guys. Thumbs up, thumbs down. Don't forget to subscribe. See you next time. Cheers.